as well. The Zoe available, but also the Lee Sin for SOFM. So a couple of really easy comfort picks on the side of Suning should they opt into that direction. And I wouldn't be surprised to see a bit of a slower selection when it comes to AD carries from Suning, since Ashe and Caitlyn are both banned.
Yeah, and if they do want to go for something like Lee Sin Zoe, that's obviously a very strong 2v2, provides a lot of burst, and it would attack where Suning have been looking to attack all series long.
This would be really interesting to see both solo lanes locked in from the side of Suning so early in the draft on red side, when you have the counter pick that's so often used for the solo lanes.
I don't believe it, Munchables. It won't happen. Oh god,
it's actually happened.
It's happened.
Well, Bin looked great on the gangplank. We've seen it recently, and he looked exceptional in that pick.
I wonder what Mo will pick in the Zoe, right? He could go for the Syndra like we saw Angel do last time around. Something else we've highlighted is LeBlanc, which can go toe-to-toe to it in the mid lane, but the other options you have are all, I'd say, not really necessarily neutralizing lanes, but things that do just want to farm up and scale up, like this Orianna pick. And we saw Mol against FPX did have a phenomenal game. The thing that's a bit confusing, though, is we see them try to play this early pressure style two games in a row. Didn't exactly work out either one, despite the game one win. And now they're wanting to switch gears.
Yeah, changing up the style here for V5, looking towards a later stage style composition with scaling in the AD carry and in the mid lane. And Huanfeng immediately locks in this Jhin. And we have seen Huanfeng succeed on the Jhin across the course of the split. He's played it 4 times. I'm curious to see it into the Ezreal.
I think he was the only one who pulled it out in spring. And I was actually talking to some coaches from teams about Jhin, and they actually felt like into Ezreal it is still a fine pick, right? You're still going to have the presence in lane, and you're going to be able to set up and have a lot of impact like someone like an Ashe would.
I mean, it's worth mentioning the reason that Jhin, or one of the reasons that Jhin came into the meta again, is it's great against Ashe and Caitlyn because it has the push power, has the trade patterns to be able to deal with them in lane. And so against an Ezreal that doesn't have that same pushing power, doesn't have the same trading power, Jhin's going to look fine.
And the thing I love about Suning's comp is it has a lot of tools to be aggressive early game coming out from the Zoe and the Jhin. Even the Cannon Barrage coming out level 6 from the GP. And their siege potential is absolutely amazing.
Yuumi going to be banned away here from the side of Suning. There's only one cat allowed, and it's in their logo, banning the rest of Rengar ban immediately to...
That's actually really interesting, too, because PBGod hasn't played Yuumi all split. Of course, right, the Ezreal could set up for them.
To be fair, this isn't really a strategy that we've seen much from B5, right, in recent games. Going for the scaling. So maybe Suning having a read on what they're expecting to see out of B5. Lilia ban as well to remove the potential top side duo that we've seen Weiwei really opt into.
And now I wonder if Suning will just want to take jungle here, since jungle is a very easy blind pick, or if you go with something like a Nautilus, which at least you have the point-click ultimate to deal with something like an Ezreal, unlike Leona, who all of your abilities right are more skill shot oriented.
So Tahm Kenshin banned away here by B5. And I would love to see, you could just go for the Nautilus once again for Sword Art here. But there's a conversation as well to be had about just getting yourself this jungler, because both sides haven't gone for the jungle just yet. And it looks like SOFM goes for the solo.
Well, the thing is, like we just pointed out, jungle is definitely a much more blindable role. Like, you don't really need to worry too much about jungle counterpick, to where support counterpick can be quite impactful for how the bottom lane laning phase goes.
I just want to point out, Suning's vote was on, like, I think 15% before that last game. Now it's all the way up to 35%. The fan vote at home certainly started to look a little bit better for Suning. Still in favor of V5 for now, though, as Weiwei goes for this Trundle once more. It's something that he has regularly fallen back on across the course of the split. And actually, towards the start of game number 2, looked really great.
Yeah, and it just fits their composition really well, right? We've talked about scaling, but hey, now they're going a bit of a different direction. They're going to have this poking bot lane that's going to be able to get priority by itself. Now I want to see where Suning answer, because Sword Art has a lot of cheap picks. Sword Art can pull out something a bit stranger like a Morgana pick, or it can just go for hard engage and you look to all in the lane and play with your jungler.
It would not surprise me at all to just see something like the Leona or Nautilus. These are the two that he's been playing regularly across the course of the split. Nautilus really feels like the go-to, which is surprising to say about Sword Art.
I even like it up against Ezreal compared to like your other potential options, right? Just having that point and click CC, but it is a bit strange that Nautilus has been what we've known Sword Art for in recent memory, but the thing I love about this comp is, once again, Suning very cognizant about, hey, we're playing for these early game skirmishes. This is what V5 loves to do, and we're just going to draft a composition that can do it better.
I have to to see, because there's a good amount of scaling on both sides of the board here, but I'm curious about this jungle matchup once more, because it feels like this series so far has been dictated by SOFM and Weiwei. SOFM starting much more aggressively in game two than he did in game number one. Weiwei had some answers in the early game.
Yeah, to me, it's going to all come down to how these junglers can interact with bot lane, because especially Victory 5, having Lux, who's a very fragile champion, if they can get a dredge line there with Olaf first, and she gets bursted out, she has to burn a flash, it feels like the game's going to be extremely tough for V5, and they're not going to be able to contest for any Drakes early on in the game at all.
And it's worth mentioning as well, once Olaf hits level 6, there is nothing Lux can do to survive that angry Viking. He's going to run her down. So we'll see what PP God has up his sleeves as we get ready for game number 3. But I'm curious about this mid lane once more. Angel and Mole have been going toe-to-toe, and this time it's Angel with the Zoe once more.
Yeah, and I definitely like what Suning put together. I like the priority they're going to be able to get with these picks.
We'll have to see. Mole on this Orianna that we saw him bring out against FPX. Let's see if he can get a win with it against Suning. It's time for game number 3, ladies and gentlemen. Suning versus Victory 5. Suning versus a whole bunch of old Suning players here. Suning Light, as we've nicknamed them. But Victory 5, they're on the cusp of a truly miraculous run to the World Championship if they can keep getting series under their belt. They went 0-16 back in spring, and they have looked incredible since that point. All through summer, they've looked amazing. They got a 3-1 victory over FPX. And Suning is the next name on their list to chop off if they want to make it to Worlds.
Yep, and again, the dynamic of this game is going to be really interesting, because for V5, we at least have a bot lane that should be able to generate pressure up against something like a Nautilus that is a melee champion. Renekton, of course, despite the fact that the 1v1 duel with GP is quite hard, you at least have the AoE to be able to push the wave when you want. You have quite a strong 2v2 as well. The big selling point for Suning is going to be they should be able to generate pressure in mid, but their bot side 3v3 and 4v4 is also quite strong.
Don't forget, tomorrow we're going to see IG against LGD. That's our other quarterfinal. LGD looking truly exceptional yesterday when we saw them against their opponents in WE. But IG, I mean, that's a team and a half to go against.
PP gone, getting chunked pretty low. But yeah, going back to that series, honestly, despite LGD coming in the favorites, I was pretty sure they'd beat WE. They looked much better than I anticipated.
Yeah, and Xie especially. That's the thing I'm most excited about for tomorrow. Sword Art misses his dredge line here.
But they know the way they need to play this lane, right? They're playing against the poke lane. They need to look for these all-ins where they can chunk out the members of V5. They're going to hit level 2 first as well. So PP God and Sam D feeling the fire.
Yep, good respect coming out from the V5 bottom lane, though. Not going to be caught out by the level 2 all-in. Or you'd imagine not, but immediately stepping forward, PP got forced to flash. That is not the respect that I was about to compliment.
I also want to point out that, in my opinion, PP God has looked much worse on champions like Lux, Lulu, and Karma than, say, the Thresh, the Bard, the Leona. Because he is a very aggressive player, right? He does typically tend to walk too far forward. He does like to play close up with the enemy bot lane.
I would have loved to see him go for this Aftershock Lux, because we have seen some Luxes go towards the Aftershock as opposed to the Guardian. It would mean that he, in these all-ins, can be a little bit tankier, because we know how much he loves to go for these all-ins. Maybe could set up for Weiwei. Weiwei so far in this series, though, hasn't been focused on the bottom lane like he usually is for V5. He's been much more focused on trying to get BuBu ahead.
Yeah, and it's been an interesting adaptation that we've actually seen work, I'd say, but I don't feel like that style's as potent as when V5 are able to get their bot lane ahead. Right now, we do see Weiwei playing towards the bot side, so at least PP God and Sam D going to have some pressure relief from them right now. But we see SOFM making his way down now. Of course, his bottom side camps are going to come up first, but we might see a 3v3.
I'm surprised that Huanfeng and Sword Art stepped so far forward. Both summoners used, and Weiwei flashes in to follow up for the kill. Huanfeng will go down. First put to Weiwei, but in comes SOFM to try and clean up. That's one for the Viking, looking for his second one. And SOFM is all over this as Angel arrives and sooning 3-1 right now.
And it was just too telegraphed with what B5 were going for. Of course, SOFM's already coming bot side. He cleared from bottom to top. Great punish coming in from them. You have an Olaf, you have an engaged champion like the Nautilus. You're so strong in these skirmishes.
And you know, we saw Huanfeng and Sword Art, they saw Weiwei. He just cleared a ward in Tribrush, and then they pushed out in the lane. I was like, they're crazy. They're going to go down here. Turns out it was all a fake.
Yeah, and again, we already see SOFM heading down, which is kind of his natural path with clearing from bot to top. They think they can burst him down fast enough, but hey, we're an early game Ezreal, we're an early game Lux, the burst isn't quite there. Easy for SOFM to get in, hit the undertow, flashes in, gets two kills, not even for himself, because a nice guy gives one over to Angel, actually Angel picking up two of them, so now going to be able to start getting ahead, has the lost chapter, and now can consistently push out these mid waves, with Dragon coming up in 9 seconds.
That's the thing, I was getting ready to count the triple kill out for SOFM, but allows the kills to go over to Angel, and that's so damn crucial, because this Zoe, we've seen it from Mole, we've seen it from Angel across the course of the split, if you can get ahead early, you can run away with things. Angel, with two kills in his pocket already, is feeling fantastic.
And this is also why we didn't really see Sam B on this champion during the split. It was something that V5 tended to shy away from, even when it was strong. Sam B's only played 5 games of Ezreal, and it was one of the ways they lost to FPX in the regular split, was they kept forcing Sam B onto Ezreal. They weren't able to generate that bot lane pressure that they're typically used to, and they just kept dying in 2v2s, 3v2s, so on and so forth.
Fifi God stepping up aggressively so that Sam D can clear out this vision. I wasn't sure if Sword Art was going to try and find himself an all-in. But you're absolutely right, Lyric. The style of V5 here in this game feels very different to what we're used to. As Angel gets caught up by a shockwave here, has to flash over the wall. That's going to be his real flash as well, but Sam D's now caught. He doesn't have his own flash available. Oh, but that bind from PP God, that is a thing of beauty right there. Sword Art will tank up, everyone walks away.
And they're allowed to play this aggressively if they do have the confidence in being able to hit these skill shots. So on the minimap, I was gonna say, we see SOFM going and trying to bully out Weiwei. Angel is here.
I mean, let's bear in mind, this is an Olaf. Weiwei cannot 1v1, and not until level 6 when the subjugation comes on through. Weiwei gonna try anyway. He's gonna step back in, try and clear some of the vision. Pillar to keep SOFM away, and now we're gonna have a smite fight over this chicken, but SOFM wins it out. Let's bear in mind, it's an Infernal Drake to start this one off, and it feels like SOFM setting himself up to grab that.
And the thing is, we already talked about, you're going to have the pressure from mid lane with the Zoe picking up those early kills. And sure, Sam D and PB God theoretically can push, but they should feel so much threat with the lack of summoners up against this engaged bot lane. Actually, we see Weiwei.
Angel's in trouble here. Doesn't have his flash available. Surely will go down as Weiwei trying to chase this one through. Needs some support from SOFM, who arrives on the scene. Mole does still have the flash available if he wants to try and chase down the kill, but they're just going to focus down onto Weiwei. Cannon Barrage to stop Mole getting in onto play. In the meantime, Sword Art is somehow on 1 HP, taken down by the top laner as Weiwei falls to the blue buff. Angel to get the kill. That's his third of the game now. And they will get out. It's a one for one somehow.
Yeah, but ultimately, V5 dedicated to TP, Bin still safe up in top lane. He's actually getting a bit of a CS lead now from that.
Which is ideal, honestly, for Suning. They are more than happy to have a gag flag just free farming at the top side. Because let's bear in mind, Bin was still a part of the play. He used that cannon barrage to stop Maul getting involved.
Yep, and again, I'm wrong, didn't get a CS lead, but did even out the CS. But still, Suning have so much bot pressure. Should be an easy kill for SOFM.
Yep, SOFM moving in. Sampti will have the Arcane Shift available, but with SOFM having the undertow, it might just be able to close the gap anyway. Ragnarok comes on through, and Sam D doesn't have his real flash available, and that means he's going to go down. PP got the next target. The SOFM barely survived, but it doesn't matter. Huanfeng gets another one, and Weiwei's too late to his own party.
And this goes to the philosophy that we've actually seen work against V5 time and time again, is if you're willing to dedicate more resources into this bot lane, you come out ahead. And all 3 games so far, Suning have been the team that invest in their bot lane. We saw Weiwei try this time around, but didn't have knowledge of where SOFM is, didn't respect, went too far forward, and it looks like this is going to be a pretty clean snowball for the side of Suning.
And the crazy thing about this to me is that we saw in the interview, PP God was saying, we're going to tone up our aggression in this bottom side. Kalista was open. That's a pick that they have had tremendous success across the course of the split. Instead, they opt into this Ezreal, which is a totally different style to what we've seen work with V5.
Or we could have even seen something different, like them go towards the Senna like they did against FPX and play this style more oriented around the solo lanes. And sure, that's also a new, I say, facet to their gameplay, but it did work.
Certainly did, and maybe we'll see something like a substitution towards Y4, because Y4 has sort of been their go-to Senna player in that bottom lane, while we have seen Samdi play it.
But I don't want to get ahead of ourselves. If there's one thing that I know, Victory 5 are never out Munchables.
That's true. They are a team that is known for hitting their head against something until it will work. We've seen it in both games so far of this series, and it worked pretty well in game number one. Suning are ahead right now, 1,500 gold, but it's certainly not over just yet.
I mean, but I could talk from first-hand experience. They slammed their head against my heart, and, you know.
16 times back in Spring, exactly. To be specific.
And it just won me over more each time.
I will say, though, my eyes are drifting towards the scoreboard of Angel and SRFM right now, because Angel is massive. He's just found a trouble bubble onto Samdi. Assuming want to contest for this Herald. You can see Huanfang moving over, and SRFM just going to run through the jungle. PP gun's gone. Angel gets the kill on that one as Sword Art uses himself for stopwatch. SRFM still survived. He's healing off the subjugation, and now curtain call to corral the whole squad of V5 in one place, looking for a fourth shot, but it won't find a kill. But hey, they got themselves a Herald, and SRFM gets out of it.
And I can see what V5 are going for, right? They rotate their bot lane up first. They're hoping they can secure this Herald with the pressure they've generated from top. But still, you're an Ezreal only with pickaxe and tier. Your Orianna only had 2 amp tones up against a Zoe who already has Sword Shoes, Lost Chapter. They also have a Jhin with BF Sword. There's no way you're going to come out ahead in this fight at this point in time. And this is also why this kind of composition doesn't theoretically fit Victory 5. Because Victory 5 are going to slam their head against the wall and hope it works. And sadly, with these items on these champions, you're just not at the point where you can fight Suning.
Yeah, this is not the composition where you fight for early Heralds. Vin now finding himself in a 1v1, but the stun was used. See you later, Bubu. I'm out of here.
Yeah, and I mean, Vin escapes.
Oh, thank God, there's plenty more coming. Flash available for Mole, but in a 1v3 right now, and Huanfang happy to follow the flash for a kill.
And Suning right now doing a great job. The roles have just completely reversed.
Yeah.
Suning are being so proactive, playing with a lot of the signature picks we highlighted for V5, and they're looking amazing. Great game coming out from Angel so far. Also, really good play from Huanfang and SOFM.
I have to say, if we were watching this without nameplates on, I would think that the red team was V5 right now. From the way that we're seeing them play, from the picks that are coming through, from the slow style of gameplay that V5 are trying to employ, it's not the style that works for them, and they're not even playing slow.
So, Suning have played Trundle, Olaf, Ezreal, and Lux all more than the members of V5. They've played all 4 champions V5 are playing more than them.
And they're trying to prove why as they make yet another play happen on the bottom side. Samdi engaged upon final spark from PP God. That they have to back away. Trisha Barrage as well. It's a lot of long-range damage, but they can't quite finish the kills off. Sword Art, though, unfortunately on the wrong side of this play. Has his flash available. Oh, no way can he get out of this one. Samdi finishes it off.
Yeah, just nice pick coming out from them, and we see Mole rotating over. They're trying to secure maybe another potential kill in bot, but at least generating some pressure for this turret.
Good respect coming out from Suning to just get out of the play. That was a little close, but Angel gets out of it.
You know, looking at my notes, going back to my last point, it even goes the reverse way. V5 have played Olaf, Zoe, and Jhin more than Suning have. So these teams really have pretty much traded comps that we've seen them all split log.
Which is something that you don't see very often in League of Legends.
And not in playoffs.
The thing is, it doesn't feel like strategically and stylistically V5 have changed. It feels like the same team, just playing different champions.
Yes.
Whereas Suning, we are seeing a dramatic shift in the way they are playing the game, and it's all off of SOFM on this Olaf. He is the catalyst for everything that's been happening.
Yeah, and they're still aggressively moving forward. Sword Art having his full combo available can set up these picks. Dragon coming up in 20 seconds, so Suning just guaranteeing some vision. They should be able to get this one scot-free. If I was V5, I wouldn't even contest. Bin also has Cannon Barrage available. Just keep buying time, go make a play up towards Bubu's lane.
I love how Bin just walks through Bubu to get into this top lane here. Should be able to clear away the minions. Did miss the cannon though. That's gonna be in a mega lull from me. But now as we look towards the mid lane here, SRFM moving in. No Herald available, but Sword Art is pinching. Flash to get the knock upon Maul and That's a Clockwork Lady going down.
And we've seen this play two games in a row now, making the pincer around one core member with your AD, carry, support, and jungle. They do it, they find the kill. They should be able to guarantee this turn and even make their way towards Dragon.
It was Samdi in game two, and now it's Maul in game number three. Cannon Barrage will clear the wave, which means Weiwei cannot finish that tower off for himself. Angel, in the meantime, splitting in the bottom side. And once again, we're seeing Suning run away with a game, but this time, far more convincingly than game number one or game number two. They are 5,000 gold ahead at 15 minutes, Larry.
And I just can't keep doing anything but praise their planning coming into this series, because they're taking away the bread and butter picks away from Victory 5. They have a 5k gold lead at this point.
Uh-oh, Weiwei thought that this was his play he was making, but this angry Viking is going to shut him down. Can't quite finish the kill, the Guardian comes on through, and I'm wrong all along. It's SOFM that falls Bubu to grab the kill.
And ultimately, it looked good. It looked like they had the burst there to take down Weiwei. Weiwei's ultimate helping him stay alive. And of course, V5 had more members on that side of the map because Suning were trying to make two plays at the same time. They were trying to take Dragon, but also trying to be a little bit cheeky by getting that pick onto Weiwei. Didn't work out in the end, but still, 3.5k gold lead for Suning, two Dragons up. You also have this a bit of late game insurance policy in the GP, but I will say when it comes to late game, I do like what V5 have, obviously with the Orianna, the Ezreal. Even the Trundle's going to steal away all those tanks that's coming out from Sword Art, or even SOFM.
One thing I will say right now, when we're looking at the next couple of minutes of the game, is I want to point out Angel's items. He already has his Ludens, he's got his boots, but importantly, he's got that Oblivion Orb as well. He is at a point where I think maybe only Bubu could survive a Trouble Bubble and then a Paddle Star out from the side of Angel. He is in one-shot territory of just about anyone on the side of V5.
Yeah, he's going to, like you said, I think you pretty much summed it up perfectly. I'm interested to see where his build goes from here, because he could go pretty much the ultimate snowballing route, maybe just go straight towards a death cap. I wouldn't assume he needs a Void Staff because there's no MR coming out on the side of V5, so give me the confidence.
Yeah.
Give me the death.
And just look at where the gold is on this team as well. Both Angel and Huanfeng are snowballing out of control right now. And SOFM, even though he died in that last play, I cannot praise him enough. 100% kill participation. As I said during one of the plays earlier, he is the catalyst of everything that has been happening for Suning. He is leading the charge.
Yeah, and I'm just very impressed with Suning, because I honestly, coming into the series, I thought Suning against FPX or V5 would be an underdog in my mind with the form they came out of the regular split in. They weren't looking good in a lot of their series. Heck, they almost lost to FPX with Doinb playing bot, Gimgun playing mid, and Khan top. So things were not on a good trajectory, but they had the time off. We always knew they had the individual talent there. The question was, could they bring it together? The series has just answered yes.
The hilarious thing is, V5 then went on to beat FPX with their proper roster, and now Suning are looking incredibly good against V5. I would argue that FPX actually probably looked better with Khan as the AD, or I guess Doinb as the AD carry in their series against Suning than what we saw from them in playoffs. But now the siege begins in this mid lane. Damage down, that's going to be Bubu, stunned up, rooted down. Will survive for now, still has that Dominus available for himself, but Suning could do this all day.
And let's remember that V5 are the ones who banned out their own strategy. They were the ones who banned out the Ashe on blue side.
Another Trouble Bubble. That's going to be PP God using his Mikhail's on himself here. Not the ideal moment.
Honestly, Munchables, at this point in the game, with this gold lead, with this Drake lead, with the items that you've talked about,
don't say it.
All V5 can do is, you know, take the punishment, absorb the pressure, hope you can live to fight another day.
Don't you dare cast a curse it, because I need Suning to win for my predictions here. Root comes on through, Cannon Barrage to follow up, Weiwei forced out of the play. True Shot Barrage comes through as the curtain call trying to follow up here. Samdi needs to be a little cautious, has to Arcane Shift out of the play as Weiwei slowed down. Might just be falling next on this one. Sword Art looking for a dredge line, but he won't quite find a target here. And in the meantime, SOFM is being chased out of the play. I don't know how this has happened, but it looks like he will get away from Maul in the end. Although Maul is not going to stop running anytime soon, not going to stop chasing here. Undertows can come out for the slow. Maul flashes forward but misses the dissonance. SOFM has a TP coming in. Bear in mind, low health Olaf is scary, and we got a play on our hands. Everybody arriving. Samdi TP's in as Bubu gets the first kill. Angel and Bin on the play. 2v3, 2v4, in fact, as they try and turn this one on its head. But PP God is here. Flash out from Bin, but the root lands. Final spot comes in. The orange isn't enough. enough. Huanfeng now arriving. Root comes in. Angel over. But he misses the paddle star. Sam D now trying to chase down the kill. He's got his flash available. Huanfeng chased out by the pillar here as Weiwei looking to close the gap. Sword Art out of the play. And the slow from the Riptide might just disengage here. There are still towers available.
Munchables, I just want to know how we ended up in this situation that we're chasing an Olaf across the map and we have time for all the members to follow in. I was scared for Mo in that situation.
Yeah.
Why are you chasing this Olaf? All the Victory 5 members somehow get there first. They pick up two kills, so they get a bit of gold back in their pockets. And that's what we talked about for V5. They're at a point in the game where they are just buying time to pick up items on this Orianna and this Ezreal.
There's a route onto Weiwei, and SFM looks like he wants to follow up. Undertoes keep on coming out. Huanfeng has a lot of damage to work with here. The slow out of the Storm Razor. Weiwei, subjugation can't save him now. Called through, slow onto PP God here, but he's looking for Sam D. Fourth shot goes wide, and Angel flashes just a moment too late. Nice little flash out of Sam D. Can they finish off the damage here? Angel gets the kill onto the AD carry of V5, and now the siege can continue.
Exactly, and we can see Suning just push forward. Maul looking for an aggressive pick. So Suning gonna take the safer approach despite having a 30-second death timer on Sam D. 20-second, I'm sorry. They are just gonna turn and look for this dragon.
And SOFM in the meantime, even though he's the jungler, he's going to be on the top side of the map getting himself a Rift Herald because the rest of Suning can quite happily take control here. Weiwei died during that last skirmish, so there's no smite contest.
Munchables, Scuttle Crabs do grow up into Rift Heralds, but they are not Rift Heralds
quite
yet. Is that
true, though?
I don't know.
I feel like they get Void Corrupted.
I can't remember who told me that. I think it was Hysterics, but...
I mean, I don't know if I trust that as a source.
Well, we see V5 going for the turn in mid lane. They overstep, they overstay, not really overstep, just a bit too long to guarantee that gold. And then, you know, nice undertoes coming out from SOFM to keep them there. Curtain call opened up. And then they're able to get the slows onto Sam D. He is going to have to flash to not take the sleepy trouble bubble. Still ends up in a position he'd rather not be in, nowhere for him to go. Goes down in the end.
Well, Finn suddenly finds himself alone here. Shockwave going to be used. Everybody using everything they can from the side of V5. And Finn should go down eventually on that play. In the meantime, SOFM has got low, but Sam D is alone in the pit. Flashes over the wall. In fact, Arcane Shifts gets out with his life. It's just going to be a one-for-one across the board.
Yeah, somehow PP got going down. And
I wish we saw the start of all of that.
Me too, but we've actually seen in situations like this, this is one of V5's big weaknesses, is especially their duo lane ends up separated on the map so often from the rest of their team, whether it's catching waves too far forward in lane or looking for vision aggressively, it has been a point of attack for other teams against Victory 5. Oh,
Suning.
Hey, thank you, Observer.
Oh, so it was just Suning trying to force a play onto PP God, and in the meantime, the play happening on the top side of the map.
It was V5 spot lane aggressively pushing it for vision, and Suning like, hey, we'll take those.
We've seen that multiple times this series as well, where it's this time Suning face checking into V5. Sword Art has to dredge line to get out of there. True Shot Barrage not going to land though.
We have two items on Angel compared to only one and some components for Mole.
Sword Art is getting hammered away out here, but he's quite happy to be the target. Of all of the players on Suning, he's the one that wants to take the beating the most here.
I think we need to remember that V5's comp obviously has some great poke coming out for both PP God and Sam D. Suning should be have a decent answer coming out from the Zoe, but, you know, I agree with Colonel.
I do too. And, like, I want to kind of remind the viewers why we're in this situation, because obviously the last couple of fights have looked pretty even. It's looked like V5 are doing a good job, but we have 5 kills on either of the carries of Suning. Both Angel and Huanfeng are massive at this point, and Jin, he ain't going to slow down anytime soon. Both of these carries scale exceptionally well. Curtain Call to start a fight here. True Shot Barrage to answer somewhat. Is Curtain Call not going to do a whole lot of anything, though?
No, and Suning trying to do what they've done in the past two games, create this vision disparity in the river, and we always know V5 are just going to walk straight in.
V5 devil. They are going to walk straight into the jungle now, getting onto SOFM. Can a barrage onto the rest of the squad, though, as Bin steps forward? Keep your eyes on whether Bin can get these barrels down in the skirmish. Weiwei gets the McHales from PP's God to keep himself safe. Are both teams disengaging here?
And yeah, I'm surprised that V5 are managing to get through this scot-free. Again, Suning still have more than a 4K gold advantage. Like we mentioned, Mole hasn't even finished his Spellbinder yet.
I think I see why Suning aren't fighting though. Even though I feel like Suning probably could just win the fight right now, we've got a Mountain Dragon coming up in 1 minute 30. If they can just maintain control of the game right now, get themselves a Mountain Soul, this is over.
Even looking at items, where Huanfeng is almost at picking up his IE, which is obviously when he's going to be hitting like a truck. So this is more tempered suiting that we saw throughout the regular split, was them not going for these really cheeky or over-egregious picks. They did typically wait for those key objectives to come up and play around those spikes.
Interesting to see this build coming out from Bin as well. Instead of going for the Essence Reaver IE that we so regularly see on the Gangplank, trying to become a bit more of a bruiser and a bit more of a pseudo-frontline, I guess, for the rest of his characters.
Yeah, and I guess it could make a bit of sense when, right, Olaf isn't really a true frontliner, and even Nautilus, right, wouldn't be as tanky as your traditional, like, top lane tank that's actually getting resources invested into it.
So now, Drake spawning in 40 seconds, Lyric. What are the expectations for this fight? What does Suning have to do to actually get the fight they want?
I feel like if I'm Suning, you can just group up mid as five. You're going to have the pressure. You're going to be able to turn straight towards Dragon, get the vision set down. And then we've seen throughout the series what Zoe can do, but Suning going to force a Baron. And obviously, they're not looking to actually do the Baron. They want to turn onto V5.
They forced the TP out of Samdi in the mid lane to make sure everyone's coming in. Baron is down to half here, way over the wall. Suning will back away. Been just hanging around in case something truly kicks off. There's V5 trying to wrestle control. They do have control of the mid lane right now. As SRFM is getting pretty low. True Shot Barrage here. Suning might have stayed a little bit too long. Root comes out. Ragnarok forced as well. Suning back away, but I don't know if they're going to be allowed out here. Mole stepping forward, but he's going to be Huanfeng has so much damage. You cannot step that far forward against Jin. And now Weiwei has to smite just to get his Nimbus Cloak to try and escape. But PP God's here. That's going to be a trouble bubble coming on through, but it's another kill for Angel as Samdi does not have the damage to turn anything around.
And a 2-for-1 so far. Looks like V5 might just accept. Okay, they're coming back in, but really egregious decisions coming out from Mole. They might be able to stop this one with the poke coming out from Samdi. Weiwei does have smite available.
No Dominus available for BuBu as he'll try and look for a way into the play here. Samdi can tank this all day long, but Angel forced to flash out of the play here. BuBu takes a massive chunk, but the stuns come on out. Bin trying to tank this one up as the crit comes through. Huanfeng counting to four, everybody, as he lands these autos, and it's Angel to finish the kill.
And ultimately, Suning having the patience to bait out this play, picking up a ton of kills. 8-17 is not a position I thought we'd be in here, and Suning have still been on Soul Point this whole time.
And I have to say, even with the scoreline, these fights are exceptionally close. I don't feel like Suning should be this close to the wire when they're this far ahead.
Once again, it was close, like you're saying, with Mole not even partaking in any of that. Mole got bursted out before the fight even started. No Shockwave, no QWs, no nothing coming out. And honestly, this is probably the worst like series we've seen from Mole this whole split.
Yeah, Mole is struggling under the pressure. And let's bear in mind, Mole is the guy that this team was built around. There is a huge amount of pressure on the shoulders of Mole to be the guy that can lead this squad to victory, to a semi-final placement in playoffs, to the World Championship.
Yeah, and again, not showing up, and even PB God mentioned in interviews that Mole is typically the one that keeps the team morale good, the team spirit high. If he's one of the members crumbling, it makes you wonder what's happening. On the reverse, as we see Sword Art's player cam with how much he's talking, Sword Art is an extremely loud player. Like, I remember at IEM hearing the flash wolves on stage, like you can hear them screaming from so far away, and it all comes from Sword Art. So that's very momentum based, right? If they can get a lead, if he can start bringing up everyone's spirits with him too, that's sort of a buff for Suning.
And we said it right at the start of the day, you could see as soon as they stepped out onto the stage, Sword Art's got a massive grin on his face. He's putting his arm around Huanfeng, making sure Huanfeng's getting in on the banter as well, keeping the spirits high for the team. And that's an incredibly valuable player to have on your squad. And it feels like Sword Art is really coming back into his own this split.
Yeah, and I do want to highlight another one of his teammates. Despite Angel finishing the Morello, which I don't care for, we didn't talk about it. He is going for a third item death cap. I love that. But once again, we're forcing a pick around Baron.
V5. BuBu forced to teleport here as he needs to get in onto the play. Barrage across the team here. Can a barrage to try and disengage the fight? Mole caught by the root. My goodness, the damage from the paddle star. And the fourth shot, Huanfeng the sniper getting the kill here. Redemption across the team though, so V5 stay healthy. His Bin tries to step on forward, but the paddle star dashed away from as SOFM tries to close the gap, get in the slow onto Weiwei. V5 surviving for now. Redemption, though, coming out from Angel now to keep Suning on the forefront in this fight.
Honestly, Sam D is the only thing keeping V5 in this game. Sam D's doing such a good job of hitting those skill shots, keeping the members of Suning low, and once again, Mole just getting completely burst before he can even do anything. No shockwave once again.
And once again, Suning can just start this one up again. Let's bear in mind, this is an Olaf. He's okay with being low health. Low health is his comfort zone, so he's happy to tank this Baron up. They have the damage to just burst this one on through. Weiwei has to contest once again. True Shot Barrage, but the slow, the root, the jungler is down for V5. And Suning, they're just going to keep this up all day.
And with the double mountain, with the shield coming through, the poke doesn't even hurt as much as you know it would otherwise.
And Sword Art is arriving once again. PP God's just used his root, and he'll get caught by the dredge line. A trouble bubble is there, and Sam D trying to flash out, but the crit comes through. The fourth shot is there, and Huang Feng survives. Bubu gets into the back of the pit, but the Baron is too high health. It's going to be saved and then smited. In fact, Sword Art's the one to get the Baron.
Well, Bubu did a great job. When the fight was happening, Bubu got into the pit. Bubu took out SOFM by himself, but sadly, the rest of the members of Suning were able to easily take down V5's horses. And I mean, we have Mountain Soul for Suning. We have Baron for Suning.
And let's just revisit what we were talking about right at the very start of this game. This composition is not what we see from V5. They are not a late-game scaling team. This is not the way that they have succeeded throughout the regular split.
They have the shortest average game time in the LPL for a reason. We see this start up. We see Mole get bursted on the fourth shot.
God.
Just absolutely amazing coming out with that ultimate. And then we see just V5 were able to do a good job of kiting out from there, but obviously, like you said, Suning able to just turn back towards that Baron with the Olaf.
And, I mean, Huang Feng, he's living the Jin dream right now. He's got four crit items. He's got a bonus BF sword on top of all of that. You get hit by his fourth shot, he's pretty much just going to one-shot Mole or something.
Even his ultimate, as we saw there, just hitting so hard.
Yeah,
his Q as well. I mean, anything, right?
The shot on Mole wasn't even the fourth shot.
Yeah.
And it still just annihilated him.
So.
But now they get to continue this one. They've got the Baron. They've got a Mountain Soul.
And they are sieging 5v4 because Mole was taking blue.
That's a four-letter word that we all know. T-I-L-T potentially coming out from Mole. He's meant to be the leader of V5. He's the guy that's got to rally the squadron off the back of this one because it's feeling like Suning are going to be going 2-1 up in the series. There's a route onto Weiwei. They're trying to finish off the tank first. The minion autos won't quite finish the kill. And now the curtain call is being blocked by once again, the sniper on the Jin finding a route and a crit onto Bubu. He can just kite around the fight all day long. Bubu gets one onto Angel, but it's not going to matter because this is all about Huang Feng at this point. Dancing around the fight, weaving these auto attacks and trying to finish this game off. They've got the Baron. They've got a minion wave coming in the bottom lane. It's not quite here just yet. Another route from Huang Feng. V5 are holding off.
Oh, wow. Sam D going in so aggressively.
He's trying to close the gap onto SOFM, but it's not so simple. Huang Feng did get rooted, but that's two inhibs falling. Suning decide, not just yet. We've got 10,000 gold, we've got a Baron, we've got a Soul, but Elder's up in 50.
Exactly. You know, I don't feel like things like scaling even matter at this point, right? It doesn't matter that Orianna and Ezreal are on the other side. Suning just have way too big of a lead. They have way too much damage, way too much burst. And we see it start off here. V5 are trying to hold their own. We see Sword Art hit an amazing dredge line. They almost burst out Weiwei, and V5 don't stack correctly. Great shot in from Huang Feng. Exactly. Great coming in from him. V5, a bit of missteps. They keep going forward. Bubu tries to bring it back. Six string turn the Renekton. He's done his best, but Suning have just been too good this game.
And it feels so good to see Huang Feng coming into his own because we know Huang Feng is one of these late game AD carries that is going to carry you if you give him the time to do it. And we're finally seeing a game in the series where he has the time to scale up and start to strut his stuff. Curtain call now as they try and engage in the mid lane. Vin stepping forward, but takes a good chunk for himself as SOFM happy to be the front line here. Curtain call not going to lead to too much. Suning needs to be careful because they lose this Elder Dragon, they could still lose the game.
Yep, this is the moment for V5 to find that 50-50, whether it's a Smite, whether it's a Shockwave, if they can guarantee that Elder.
There are super minions pushing in the base. All Suning needs to do right now is keep V5 busy, keep them in the play, and the super minions will end the game. Yubu has gone to answer exactly that. He has Teleport. It's 4 versus 5 right now. The Root comes down onto PP God, has to use this for Chaos as a Sleepy Trouble Bubble. Comes down onto SamD. Forced away as Huanfeng backs away, drops a Vel'Koz, and now they'll start this dragon.
And they just don't do any damage as we see there. Right now, Double Mountain Suning are just too big for the members of V5 to deal with.
And let's bear in mind, Huanfeng, he's full build at this point. TP going to be forced as Suning back away from the dragon. They're going to go for Maul instead. Gets a shield, but SOFM cuts him down. Weiwei, the next target, he tries to escape. PP got as well low, but Huanfeng goes forward to get the kill, and they want a croc on top of it as well. Another for SOFM, and this is just easy pickings at this point. Suning are looking for game number 3. Suning are looking for the upset here as V5 are falling before our very eyes. You can see a recall coming through for SamD, but he's not going to be home in time for dinner.
Yeah, and Suning showing a great performance on this early game composition, shutting V5 out.
The Lions making a feast right now of the Priest as we go to game number 4 and Suning 2-1 up in the series.
And once again, I just want to keep highlighting their game plan coming into the series has been so well, taking away so many of the crucial picks coming out from V5. The individual skill is on point today. And when we're talking about Suning, the mechanics need to be there. SOFM's been playing exceptional. Every Dredge Lion from Sword Art has hit this game. Like, every single one looked phenomenal.
Yeah, Sword Art's looking exceptional. SOFM as well. I love that SOFM is so damn decisive on this Olaf. He sees you out of position. He lands one under toe. He's gonna run at you. He's gonna chase you down and finish a kill.
Let's also highlight Huanfeng, who we haven't really talked about this series, despite, like, Suning are a weird team. That I feel like Huanfeng is a top 4 ADC in the LPL, but Suning don't play for him. So he's very self-sufficient. A lot of his damage numbers just come from him peeling for himself, him setting himself up. And we saw that this game having some phenomenal ultimates, some great Ws, and just constantly in a position to dish out damage for his team.
Yeah, beautiful stuff. And using this Jhin really effectively, yep, as well. We always talk about this Jhin pick as like a utility pick, but when you get to the late stages of the game, when you've got 100% crit, that fourth shot one-shots people. Yep. Being able to be that late-game hyper-carry that we know Huanfeng to be.
Yeah, Jhin late-game is a burst mage, right? Like one combo and someone's just gone. And let's highlight the fact that Huanfeng was one of the players who actually brought Jhin out in spring, yeah, when it wasn't meta. It just shows he's very comfortable on this champion. It's in his repertoire, and he looked great.
Interesting as well to see Bin playing this different style of Gangplank, where he's not looking to be the hyper carry for the team, because like, he was still building his Triforce when Angel and Huanfeng got ahead in the early game. So he then had the option and was like, you know what? I don't need to be the hyper carry. I don't need to build pure damage. I can be a bit more of a utility Gangplank, use the ultimate for engages, and just play protection on the carries.
Yeah, and when you have like a 12-kill Zoe, I can see why he went for that choice. And talking about Zoes and Zoe players, Mole's having a rough series. Game 2 and Game 3, Mole has made some, yeah, bad positioning, some uncharacteristic mistakes. And with him out of these fights, I mean, it was so close, right? A lot of these fights were close with it being a 4v5 with Mole not being in the game. Look at Mole's damage numbers. Those are abysmal.
For a scaling mage in a 35-minute game, you've got to be hitting higher numbers than that. And the shockwaves as well. Like, if you lock in Orianna, you want these game-changing shockwaves. Mole was not able to make it happen. And that, after this split that he has had, is such a disappointing sentence to say.
And let's remember, this is Mole's second time playing Orianna this split. The first time was in playoffs against FPX 2 days ago. So this is not a champion we know Mole for. This is not a style we know V5 for. And you guys can see why. When we get to the first Dragon fight, when we get to the first Rift Herald fight, V5 are looking for these fights when, hey, you have a Jhin on the opposite side with the BF Sword. You have a Zoe with the Lost Chapter where your Ezreal has Tear, your Orianna has 2 amplifying tomes.
And I have to say, Lyric, I'm a firm believer in team style is more important than the perfect draft, right?
Yeah.
In my opinion, I think V5 need to go back to what has worked for them in the past. Get themselves this Kalista in the bottom lane. Get something like the Galio or the TF in the mid lane that you can just force these skirmishes in the early game. Brawl with Suning. That is where V5 have been their strongest the entire season. I want to see that again.
The Sindra was open this game, and Mole had so many game-changing Scatter of the Weeks during the split. And
yeah,
again, we're not seeing these champion picks come out, and they're getting punished.
Yeah, it's been a rough series so far for V5, but Suning, they're over the moon with the way this one is going. 2-1 now. We're going to go to a quick break. Do join us afterwards, because we'll see if Suning can finish things off right after this.